It's my first day of senior high.
Are you finally gonna let me make some decisions of my own? I asked my mom while she insisted that I take at least 2 servings of fruit and 3 servings of vegetables to school. She didn't only control my life, she controlled every single aspect of my life. The clothes I wore, the friends I let come over, the subjects I did at school, and even my extracurricular activities. I wasn't allowed to go to sleepovers, parties, concerts, or anything fun. Before I continue telling you about my extremely annoying mother, please like the video and subscribe to the channel. Hit that notification bell if you never ever want to miss out on a story again. I lived with my mom, stepdad, and 2 younger sisters in Hawaii. My mom and I moved there when I was 3 years old, and I don't really remember much about our previous life. She told me I was born in Michigan, and I had 1 picture of myself making snow angels, but that's about it. I had no idea who or where my dad was. I guess that things didn't work out between him and my mom. She didn't ever speak about him, and I didn't really care because my stepdad was awesome and so were my 2 little sisters. Anyway, back to that morning, I was begging my mom for more independence.
Carmi, you're still a child, and you have to do whatever I tell you,
she insisted. I picked up my backpack and went outside to wait for her. Oh yeah, she drove me to and from school every single day. And my new high school was only about 5 minutes away. I could have walked, but she refused to let me. Can you believe it?
I'll pick you up at 3,
she said as she kissed me on the cheek. Whatever, Mom, I sighed. I had a really awkward day, but it was amazing. Most of my friends from middle school were in my class, but there were some new faces. The one which struck me the most was Kai. You know how some girls have an idea of the person they want to marry and spend the rest of their lives with? Well, Kai was mine. He was perfect, and I just needed to wait for the right opportunity to talk to him.
Just talk to him now. He's right over there,
my best friend Claudia said. Okay, fine, I'll go, I replied. We were in gym class in the middle of a basketball break. I held a basketball in my hands and tried to spin it around. I walked over to Kai and accidentally dropped it on his foot. He smiled, bent down, and picked it up.
That's a cute ball, isn't it?
He said. What? Yes, it is, I replied, a bit confused.
But not as cute as the person who dropped it on my foot on purpose,
he laughed. I blushed and ran to where Claudia was standing. She looked just as excited. Oh my gosh, I think he likes me too. He called me cute. I'm totally freaking out. I'm in love, I squealed. After school, my mom was already waiting for me, and I just got this sinking feeling that my high school life would suck if she didn't give me a break soon. If she kept micromanaging my life, how would I ever get the chance to go on dates with guys or really get to know my future husband, Kai? I felt depressed until the next day when I saw Kai's beaming face again. That day, he left his group of friends and came to sit next to me in the cafeteria.
So, what do you like to do for fun, cute girl?
He asked. I didn't know what to reply because I was so nervous. I ended up spilling orange juice all over my shirt while I stared at him in shock. When we were eventually able to have a conversation, I realized that he was such a sweet person. Just before the bell rang for us to go back to class, he said,
Would you like to go and watch a movie with me this Saturday?
Sure, I'd love that, I replied. I'd have to ask my mom, obviously, but I was a high schooler now, so how could she refuse?
Absolutely not!
She screamed at me over dinner. My sisters and stepfather sat in silence. I'm old enough to go on dates now. Do you really want me to be alone forever? I replied.
You're not old enough. Case closed. Besides, I signed you up for a pottery class that afternoon, and you have swimming classes in the morning. You don't have time to go watch a movie with some boy.
She argued. I'm not interested in pottery or swimming. I don't understand why you insist on treating me like a child. You're the worst mother in the universe. I screamed and marched up to my room, leaving my food on the table. I realized that in order to have a bit of independence, I'd have to create a plan. I'd have to lie. A lot. And I hated the idea of being dishonest, but what choice did I have? The next day, I had to tell Kai that something was up. I didn't tell him my mom said no, or he might have thought I was a baby. The following week, I convinced my mom that I had joined a bunch of clubs and would have to stay back at school until 5 every day. She was really happy I stopped bugging her about dating. Then I asked Kai if he'd like to hang out after school a few days a week, and of course he was happy to. The first time we spent time alone together, It was a Wednesday afternoon. We decided to grab some pretzels at the mall, and then we took a stroll through the park. We sat down on a little bench in front of a pond, and Kai did the most adorable thing ever. He started feeding the birds crumbs of his pretzel. We spoke about everything: school, our favorite TV shows, hobbies, families, everything. I was really sad when 4:30 came and I had to run back to school so my mom wouldn't suspect a thing. Kai and I did this almost every day. When he couldn't hang out, I'd just go to the library and finish my homework or something. We'd meet right after school, then walk to the park, the mall, or the cute little ice cream shop downtown. My mom didn't suspect a thing because I'd always make it back to school before 5. I was so happy at home, and she really believed it was because I was enjoying my classes at my new school. Kai and I kept this up for about 2 whole months, and then things became weird. Not because of him. It started one afternoon while we were sitting in the park talking about a movie we had both watched recently. I noticed a man dressed in black pass our bench, and I could have sworn he looked at me and made eye contact. After about 10 minutes, he passed again, looked at me, and walked away. The next day, the same thing happened. Then I didn't see him for a few days, so I sort of forgot all about him. The next week, Kai and I were sitting in the food court at the mall, eating popsicles. It was a really hot day. He was telling me a stupid joke, and I was almost lost in his eyes when I noticed a face behind him. It was that man again. We made eye contact, and he walked off. "I've got to follow that guy. He seems to be staring at me, and I don't know why," I told Kai.
"Well, if he really is a stalker, do you think it's the best idea to follow him?"
he said. He made sense, but I needed to understand why he kept looking at me. I walked slowly behind him as he disappeared into a crowd. Then he went into a little gift store. I followed and hid behind a shelf. I saw him take out his cell phone, and the conversation I heard shocked and confused me.
"Yeah, I'm sure it's her. She looks exactly like you. Yeah, okay, I'll get back to you later."
At that moment, I'd had enough. I walked up to him and tapped him on the shoulder.
Oh my, it's you, Charlotte,"
he said. "What? My name is Carmi. Why have you been following me around, and who were you talking to?"
"It's a really long story. Let's find somewhere to sit so we can have a chat,"
he replied. I realized it was almost 4:30, so I told him to meet me in the same place the next day. I ran back to Kai and told him I had to go home. The next day, I told Kai I had something important to do after school, so I couldn't meet him. Then I went to find my strange stalker. He was already there waiting for me when I arrived.
"Charlotte, Carmi, let's go somewhere where we can sit down."
We walked to the cafe in the mall and sat.
"How long have you lived in Hawaii?"
"You tell me. You've been following me around, so I assumed you have already found out that information already," I said, annoyed.
"I'm sorry for following you, and I'm sorry I came across this way. My name is Henry Davis, and I'm a private investigator. I don't even live here. I arrived a few weeks ago."
"So what does a private investigator want with me? I'm not a criminal."
"What I'm about to say to you will shock you, but I'm hoping you will remain calm and open-minded. You are not who you think you are,"
he said while sliding a few newspaper clippings across the table. I picked them up and read the headlines. "Surrogate mother disappears. Mother and father heartbroken after newborn baby vanishes. No trace of baby Charlotte." "What is this?"
"These articles are all about you."
"I don't understand what you mean. I already have a mom. You definitely have the wrong person," I said, ready to get up and leave.
"Who is your father? Do you even have a picture of him? Stay here and listen to me. Your parents are called Lillian and Mark Hill. They're a wealthy couple from North Dakota. After being married for 15 years, Lillian became frustrated because she couldn't have a child. They went to a surrogacy agency and were partnered with your mom, or the woman you think is your mom. She lived with them throughout her pregnancy, and then one morning, she went into labor. She was driven to the hospital, and somehow, she disappeared right after the delivery. Your biological parents have been searching for you for years. And a few months ago, they received an anonymous tip that you might be here, so they hired me to find you."
"Is this some kind of prank? Where are the cameras?" I asked in disbelief.
"It isn't a prank. Here are their pictures."
He handed me his cell phone. The woman in the picture looked just like me, and I began to think about my mom and how we looked nothing alike.
"Do you want to meet them?"
he asked. I didn't know what I wanted at that point, so I asked him to meet me again the next day. I had to run back to school because my mom would be back to pick me up soon. I was silent for the entire ride home. What if it was all true? I would have to leave the only person I knew as my mom, the only family I had, to be with some strangers. She would probably be arrested, and what would happen to my little sisters and my stepdad? Her overprotective nature began to make sense. Maybe she sensed they'd be coming for me and was only trying to protect me from it all. But why did she take me away from my biological parents? Why did she hide it all from me? It was too much.
Carmi, you're really quiet this afternoon. Is everything okay?
She asked after a while. Mom, who is my dad? I've never even seen a picture of him. She looked really uncomfortable and said,
There are some things that I just can't tell you yet.
I decided to tell her the truth. I told her all about the private investigator and asked her if it was all real.
Wow, they really found us. I was certain we were safe here. I'm sorry, Carmi, it's all true. I carried you for 9 months, and the instant I looked into your beautiful little face, I knew you were truly mine. I wasn't willing to give you away, so I ran. We lived in hiding in Michigan for 3 years until I met your stepdad, and we decided to move here. I hope that you can find it in your heart to forgive me. If you want to meet your real parents, you can. Now that you've discovered the truth, I can't stop you from doing what you feel is best for you.
I don't want to meet them, I said quietly after a while.
You know I love you, right?
I do. I love you too. So what do we do now?
We run.
We left Hawaii that night. We told my little sisters we were going on a vacation and got them to pack all their things really quickly. Now we live in Asia, and we all have new identities, so my biological parents can't find me. Maybe someday they will, who knows. But I'm not ready for that yet. I'm still conflicted about my mom. She did a bad thing. A very bad thing. But I don't want to leave my family. I love them. So I decided I'm just gonna keep quiet. Mom's agreed to lay off a little with the overprotectiveness because I guess she feels like she kinda owes me now, since she took me away from my biological parents. I never got the chance to say goodbye to Kai either, but it's too risky to try to contact him now. Who knew that my entire life had been a lie?